Hello, friends. How would you like to learn a few productivity hacks using some Outlook shortcuts for email? In this video series, I'm going to teach you how to create the content once and reuse it with just a few clicks. The third video focuses on Outlook templates, otherwise known as .oft files. If you've never heard of it, that's okay. Stay tuned and we'll talk about it. I'm Sue Vizcarra, the Digital Declutter Diva. Let's get started. Today's lesson is going to be much longer than the first two. I'm breaking it down into a few sections. Beginner section, we'll talk about how to create the template, how to use the template, and how to edit the template. In the intermediate section, we're going to talk about how to actually add a shortcut to your quick access toolbar, a shortcut to File Explorer, how to share a template with a friend or coworker, and how to actually create a shortcut on your desktop. And at the very end, we're going to have a brief discussion recapping all three options that you have in Outlook: the quick parts, the My Templates, and the Outlook templates, so that you can decide which method is best for your situation. For today's lesson, we are actually using Microsoft Outlook for the desktop. Let's start as usual with a new email. You'll notice that my signature auto-populated. This is how I have this set up in advance. If you have your signature auto-populated, please go ahead and delete that signature. So let's go ahead and delete the signature. Otherwise, once you create the template, your signature will end up being used twice, once in the template and then once again when you start a new email and ask Outlook to use the template. All right, so I already have some text saved elsewhere that I'm going to paste into this email, but you can start from scratch right here, create your content, format your text, add tables, add images, whatever you like. The only thing that you can't do is add a file attachment. So everything that you need needs to be in the body of this email. So I'm going to go ahead and paste what I have saved on my virtual clipboard into this email message. I'm going to add a subject. So just by copying this, adding this to my subject. All right, this is where the real magic happens. Are you ready? File, save as. Change this save as type to Outlook template. Then go ahead and choose save, because you already created a subject header. That is the file name that this is assigning to your template. I don't plan on sending this message to anyone at this time, so I'm going to go ahead and close out this new email. I'm going to receive a pop-up message asking me if I want to save my changes. This can be a little confusing. This makes you think, well, wait a minute. Didn't I just save my template? Yes, you did. It's actually asking you if you want to save a draft of this full email here. You do not. So go ahead and say no. Based on the other videos that we have covered in this series on quick parts and my templates, you may automatically think that we need to start with a new email. However, with the OFT files, we're going to start a little differently. So what I want you to do is to navigate to the ribbon here, and instead of choosing new email, I want you to choose new items. Then I want you to choose more items, and then choose form. When this window pops up, I want you to change the look in folder to user templates in file system, because you actually are the user and you created a template. You'll notice that automatically here, the one that we just created, which is called How to Create an Outlook Template, is available to us. Go ahead and select that template, choose open. Now you'll notice it auto-populated here. And now let's check to see if the signature is there as well. Yes, my signature is there as well. So now we're good to go. Go ahead and choose who you are sending this to, make any edits, And this is where you can actually attach additional files if you choose to do so. I went ahead and closed out that email. Now we're going to talk about actually editing the template. You need to locate the template the same way that we just did. New items, more items, choose form, look in, user templates, because it's what you created, how to create an Outlook template, and open. Now, before we make the edit that is going to be a permanent edit, make sure you scroll down and get rid of that email signature. We don't want that there because we are replacing the template with a revised one. Go ahead and make your edits. In this one, I'm just going to go ahead and delete a couple of the icons that I used. Now, when we do File, Save As, Outlook Template, we're keeping the same subject, the same file name. When we click Save, this is going to give us a pop-up warning letting us know that we're about to replace the original one. And yes, we want to do that. So far, we've reviewed the beginner steps on how to create, how to use, and how to edit those Outlook templates. Next, we're going to move on to some intermediate lessons. Again, adding that shortcut to the Quick Access Toolbar or File Explorer, how to share a template with a friend or coworker, and how to actually add a shortcut to your desktop to use these Outlook templates. Let's take a look at adding a shortcut to the Quick Access Toolbar, which is located at the top of your window in blue. So we're going to follow similar steps that we just did to create the template and use the template. Locate new items, more items, and I want you to hover over the word choose form. Now, typically we've been clicking with the left mouse button. This time we're going to click with the right mouse button. So see, I'm gently hovering over it. Right click, add to quick access toolbar, and you'll notice that there is a shortcut here. This shortcut is called choose form. This is definitely the one that we want. Now let's go ahead and see what it looks like to use this shortcut. Start here with choose form, look in user templates and file system, find the template that you created, and click open. So you notice in this situation, I skipped a few steps. I didn't have to go to a new email and then find it. I just started at, like, I don't know, step number 3 or 4, choose form. And remember, because I'm using a template and because it is a new email, Outlook went ahead and added my signature. Creating a shortcut in File Explorer is a little trickier. Let's go ahead and find that template. Again, it's look in, user templates and file system. Now what we want to do is actually look right here in the address bar that is telling me where my files are located. I'm going to go ahead and select all of that. Control C so that it saves to my virtual clipboard. I'm going to choose cancel. I'm going to navigate to my File Explorer, which is the yellow folder on my taskbar. I'm going to look right here in this address bar. I'm going to click on the address bar and I'm going to Control V paste the address. You need to delete the asterisk.oft, then hit the Enter key, and you are in the location where all of your templates are saved. Now that we've done this, we can actually save it as a quick access or a favorites in File Explorer. So over here in quick access, I want you to take and right click, pin current folder to quick access. You'll notice that this templates folder is now available here and it has a little push pin next to it, which lets me know that it is saved as a favorite and I can find it much quicker. I don't need to remember that trick of the address that we just went through. Let's go ahead and use that same address that we save to the clipboard and place it on our desktop. I'm going to go ahead and minimize my Outlook. I'm now in my desktop. I'm going to right click in the desktop. I'm going to look for New, Shortcut. And here's where I'm going to use Control V to paste in the address of all the shortcuts. Remember, back out all the way to the /. Choose Next. Templates is a fine name, and Finish. All right, so now we know where these templates are. Why would we want to do that? Well, let's see what happens if we click on Templates. We are now in the location of our templates. If I click on one that I've created, it automatically opens up a new email with the information in it. I did not have to actually start in the Outlook and create a new email from choosing the form. I created it directly from the desktop. The same thing goes if you actually want a direct link to a particular template that you use again and again and again. So in this situation where I have how to create an Outlook template, I'm going to right click and I'm going to make a shortcut with this, create a shortcut. I'm going to delete the shortcut, so Control X, and I'm going to paste it here on my desktop. Now another option is to actually go back to that File Explorer. The shortcut that I created, I can drag and drop over here to the desktop folder. So either one works. Let's go ahead and see what it looks like to actually use that shortcut. So notice here, this one's a shortcut to a folder. It's the dark yellow folder, and this one is just to an email. So let's double click, open it up, and there you have it. It has auto-populated. That template is ready for you to edit and send. What if you want to actually share this template with a friend so they can use it as a template? Well, you could just send it as the text in the email, absolutely, and have them follow the steps on File, Save As, the user templates in the system, and save it as a template. Or you could save them a few clicks and actually send it already in the template form. What does that look like? Well, in this situation, we actually are going to go ahead and start as a new email. And we're going to insert it just like you would any other file attachment. So up here in the menu, the Insert menu, Attach File, I'm going to browse this PC. Now remember, we actually went ahead and created a shortcut to the template. So let's go ahead and use that shortcut. Let's choose the one that we want to share with our friend or coworker and choose Insert. There it is. So now you can complete your message and send that to a friend. As a matter of fact, we can repeat this and we can send them all 20 templates that we created at once. And I think that is a great way to help out your friends with messages that are sent again and again and again. They don't have to recreate the templates because you've already done that for them. Let's do a quick recap of the different options that you have in Microsoft Outlook for using templates. You have the quick parts. Remember, they are saved locally to your PC. They're not available on the web. Best used for small bits of text, images, or tables. The My Templates is saved inside of Outlook and is available on the web. This is best used for medium bits of text and tables, but not images because there is a 32 kilobyte limit. However, one extra feature about My Templates is when you're using it on the web version only allows you to have one email signature in Outlook. My Templates allows you to bypass that limit and add other signatures as My Templates. The last option we have is the Outlook Templates, the .oft files. They are also saved locally to your PC. They can be saved to a cloud or OneDrive. However, when you use them, they're actually only an attachment. They don't actually populate into the body of the message like we want them to. This is best used for larger bits of text, images, and tables. So imagine a multi-page document. If you were to create something in Microsoft Word and it takes more than, let's say, a page, that is what you'll want to use the Outlook template.oft file for. And remember, if you are someone in an organization who can create a few of these templates and save that, share them with your peers, that will be an extra bonus for you and for them. Friends, I believe in you. You've got this. And if you need further assistance, or if you would like me to send you these instructions in an email, I'd be happy to do so. Just reach out to me at sue@suevizcarra.com. And I definitely recommend, if you haven't had a chance already, go ahead and watch the first video for quick parts and the second video on my templates. Have a wonderful day, and thank you so much for being here. Add your comments below. Let us know how you're using my templates.